is burning low. Only miss the sun when it starts to snow. Only know you love her when you let her go.
Absolutely amazing song right there. I don't know, I just love the song. And I think he's actually, you know, saying the truth. You don't know what you have till it's gone. That's exactly what they say. This is still 105.5 Paradise FM. It's the afternoon show. My name is Duke Emmanuel. 16 minutes gone past the hour, 5 o'clock. About time for Axe Slim. I got Slim in the studios. How you doing?
Hey Duke, I'm fine.
And today we're talking about the pot belly. Does the half put food in stomach? Fat in the stomach. You know, when you feel like you're adding weight, and then you just know that your stomach is growing bigger, and you know that thing that some people call comfort zone when they rub their stomach. So Slim has an overview of the whole pot belly stuff as usual. So take it away.
Okay, I need you to take a quick look around you. Did you know that many people in this era have excess abdominal fat? The first thing that comes to your mind is how ugly it looks, and the people that have them are self-conscious about showing off your body. But hold on a second, I've seen really cute ones, like really, really cute ones. However, what most people don't realize is that it's a dangerous risk factor to your health. Scientific research has clearly determined that although it's not healthy to have excess body fat throughout your body, it's also particularly dangerous to have excess abdominal fat. Owing to the fact that there are two types of abdominal fat, that is the subcutaneous and visceral fats, one has to be careful in respect to visceral fat. Visceral fat is what plays a role in giving certain men that beer belly appearance when their abdomen protrudes excessively. But at some point, there's also a sort of hard feeling if you push on it. Part of the reason this fat is dangerous is due to the fact that it releases more inflammatory molecules into your body on a consistent basis. So, if you care about the quality of your health and loved ones, reducing your abdominal fat should be one of your top priorities. Whichever way, a spare tire around the waist is uniquely dangerous because it's packed with bad fat. A US study revealed that those who are not overweight but have a bulging midriff are 2.75 times more at risk of dying from cardiovascular disease than normal weight and a proportionate waistline. We've had varying opinions as to the cause of pot belly, but the most common causes are drinking too much alcohol, eating too many bad carbohydrates, stress overload, genetics, and sedentary lifestyle. If you drink a lot of alcohol regularly, you stand a chance of getting pot belly. Mind you, beer isn't the only culprit. Alcohol contains nothing but empty calories that are stored in the stomach area. Of course, there are good carbs and bad carbs. Unrefined carbs like fruit, whole grains is good and can help in weight control. But excess cakes, biscuits, junk in general does the opposite. It can cause a rise in insulin, slow down of metabolism, and excess sugar the body can't use will be stored up like fat. Too much stress has many negative impacts on the body. It causes the body to switch to survival mode. And one way the body ensures its survival is by storing more fat so starvation doesn't occur. The toughest cause of belly fat is genetics, because it entails not being able to do anything at all to prevent it. A sedentary lifestyle is one in which a person fails to exercise regularly or fails to get an exercise at all. It could be that you're sitting on the couch and watching too much TV, or reading too much, or using the computer too much. Basically, if you're not moving around enough, it's sedentary. You can simply avoid this by moving and exercising regularly. Whether you prefer to call it a pot belly, beer belly, pooch, or Buddha belly, a fat stomach is hazardous to your health. If you're carrying a little extra heft in the meat section and your partner is getting on your case about it, I've got a suggestion. Don't blame yourself. Just accept the fact that you're born in the wrong century. You see, it used to be the in thing back then. In times past, pot belly was considered a sign of wealth and success. Those in the social class wore their bellies as a badge of honor. Captains of industry revered their girth as a symbol of wealth and power. And let's not forget sporting heroes like the summer wrestlers who are paragons of potbelliness. But come on, times have changed. A potbelly is easy to get and hard to get rid of. The key to overcoming is to learn more about it. What exactly is a potbelly? How did I wind up with one? What exactly is in there anyway? Why are some bellies hard and some soft? How do I get rid of it? Each of these questions have more answers than you can ever expect. Exercise and eating healthy is the quickest way out. Now, the next time your partner gets on your back about belly, blame it on evolution, on her great cooking, even on that job you work so hard that leaves you with no time to exercise. But don't use it as an excuse not to find a way out.
Okay, so she actually made mention of some facts that I'd like to confirm with the lifestyle expert. But don't worry, we have Mr. Clement right here in the studios. And if you have any questions concerning, you know, the whole potbelly stuff, if you have a potbelly, if you have a protruding stomach, it doesn't mean if you're slim or you're fat. You know, some people just have that stomach and they believe that because they are fat, you know, as well, that, you know, it matches. I don't know if there are other health implications and all that, but Mr. Clement will be here to talk to us about that. But right now, let's pause and listen to a song from Future featuring Kanye West. It's called I Won. Get your questions to us right now. The phone line is open, 081-2882-2614. Whatever things you like to know about the causes of belly fat and also how to lose it. Enjoy this one. We'll be right back after this.
I just wanna take you out and show you off. You already know that you the perfect one. Girl, when I'm with you, feel like a champion. Ever since I got with you, I feel like I won. Me a trophy, a trophy. I want me a trophy.
I want
a trophy. I just wanna take you out and show you off. You already know that you the perfect one. Girl, when I'm with you, feel like a champion. Ever since I got with you, I feel like I don't want me a trophy. Hey. Trophy, I want me a trophy. A trophy, I want me a trophy. Trophy, I want me a trophy. A trophy. On the dresser just to make up water. Gotta put you in that bitches, then you rockin' Poriellas. Then I leave with you, only cause I believe in you. We get the baggin' on the walls, just to piss the neighbors off. You ain't the barefoot, still is like it's painted through the halls. So I can breathe, I wanna live my dream. You say that money don't matter, it's the times and the memories that I get fatter, and I know it's because of me. I know it's because of me. Got you in custody. Whoever's knocking at the door, they gotta wait till we finish. I know I'm starting at the bottom, but that ain't what we in. I just wanna take you out and show you love. You already know that you're the perfect one. Girl, when I'm with you, feel like a champion. Ever since I got with you, I feel like I don't want me a trophy. Trophy. I want a trophy.
Number one trophy wife. So it's only right to live a trophy life. You grew up on J-Lo, Timberlands by Manolo now. Till one day I put an angel in your ultrasound. I wanna dip that go. I wanna dip that go. I made it over NBA, NFL players. So every time I score, I like go. Baby, we did it to South France. So you could run around without your pants. I put that face on your little hand. That's the only thing without a tan. My trophy on that bound bike, I gave you only pipe. If people don't hate, then it won't be right. You can look at kind of kid, but put me
and your clothes. All your mama ever made was trophies, right?
I just wanna take you out and show you out. You already know that you the perfect one. Girl, when I'm with you, feel like a champion. Ever since I got with you, I feel like I done won me a trophy. Trophy. I want me a trophy. Trophy, trophy, trophy. I want me a trophy. I want a trophy.
Okay, so most people didn't actually see that one coming. That's the collaboration that we didn't expect. Future and Kanye West is called I Won. 27 minutes gone past the hour, 5 o'clock. This is the afternoon show. My name is Duke Emmanuel, and I got Mr. Clement, a lifestyle expert right here in the studio with me. And together we'll be talking about the courses and the meats involved about pot belly and belly fat generally. So Clement, welcome to the program.
Thank you very much.
How you doing this afternoon?
I'm fine.
Okay. So real quick, you know, I know you have some overview. Like we also listened to Slim as well talking about, you know, belly fat and all that. What is the main cause? What are the major causes of belly fat?
The main causes belly fat, usually lifestyle, you know, habits, bad eating habits, and it's important people know that it could be very dangerous to their health. So mostly usually kind of habit that people cultivate with time, then it has cumulative effect, then the manifestation is the belly fat.
So that's the major cause. That's bad eating habits. Yeah. Let's talk about this eating habits. You know, what are they really? Is it the food that you're eating, or the time that you're eating the food? What the habits really about?
Yes, around here people need to know something that you know, people believe that lately I've seen people eat a lot of food. They don't they eat according to the measure of how hungry they are. And one thing they need to know is that it takes about 20 minutes for the brain to register that you're already filled. At that point, you would have eaten and overloaded the stomach.
Okay, so it takes like 20 minutes for your brain to register that you're full.
So
if you're very hungry, like if you stay for a very, very long while without eating, and then you just want to eat, you want to consume everything.
Yes,
and then,
yes.
And then at the end of the 20 minutes, you now realize that you're overfed.
Wow, you're overfed, yeah. It's important people take little food. Now, when you take that little food after like 20 minutes and you still have the feeling that you are still hungry, then you can eat more. So what we usually advise people to do is they should eat in minimum sizes. You know, they shouldn't eat like in eat so much food, and at the end of the day they won't be able to walk. So they get their system overloaded with junks, and the body really needs just a little bit of calories, you know, to keep the body going. But when you get the body stored with excess calories, and what happens is that food is converted into fat, and the easiest way, the place where this fat is stored is the abdominal area, which is eventually with time resulting to belly fat.
Okay, so like you rightly said, you know, I like the fact that, you know, you've pointed out that it takes about 20 minutes for your brain to actually let you know that, okay, I'm okay now, I'm not supposed to eat again. Yeah. Now, is there any specific type of food that, you know, causes this belly fat?
Yes, there are certain types of food. A lot of things, you know, people say starch, excess fat can cause excess intake of starch can cause it. But it's true, because when you take excess starch or sugary things, it gets your insulin level very high. And when insulin is there in excess in the system, it could result into the breaking down of food into glycogen, which is fat, which can also eventually result into belly fat. So it's not good for people to take too much of sugary things or excess carbohydrate. And the timing is also important, because sometimes people eat a lot of heavy meal at night. Around here, people take a lot of garri in the night, they take fufu in the night, you know, and they want to go to bed. And it takes about average of 4 hours before the food can properly digest. So people just eat immediately and you just lie down on their bed, you know, and the food is just there, and gets the abdominal muscle gets it a lot, it gets it so stretched out. And one thing people need to know is that this belly fat we're talking about has a way of compressing the pancreas, because the pancreas kind of it's protrude from the spleen down to the left part of the body. So over time, this belly that is growing bigger, you look at it from the outside, it's growing bigger, but it's growing bigger inside too. So it compresses some kind of organs like the pancreas.
Okay, so we'll still come to that, talking about that. You know, we live in an environment where we mostly eat starchy food. You know, yes. Sometimes someone goes, eats yam in the morning, you know, you eat gari in the afternoon, yes. And then in the evening you do noodles or you do rice. Yeah. And, you know, it's most of them are, you know, starchy foods. Now, how do you get to, you know, regulate the kind of food that you eat? You know, knowing that you're taking starch and you're supposed to take protein or you're supposed to take this or that. So, are there any specific, you know, types of food that how are you supposed to regulate your food generally so that you don't end up with belly fat much?
I think there's not much we can do about controlling the type of food in terms of starch. People will tell you, oh, if I don't eat starch, so what else will I eat around here in Nigeria, you know? I think we should emphasize more on the quantity and sizes of what people eat. Because when I look at people's plates sometimes, I feel so scared.
Well, you know, I learned that some people are just generally fat. You know, it's not like they eat plenty. You know, they eat less and then they still end up being, you know, on the big side.
Yes, that's where the lifestyle comes in. You cultivate it. You need to deliberately work at it to ensure that it doesn't happen to you.
What I'm talking about is, you know, some people that don't really eat heavily, like you actually said, yes. You know, but they're still on the big side.
That means they have the tendency to become very fat.
Okay.
Then they need to pay the price. They need to pay sacrifices to exercise more often to ensure that doesn't happen.
Okay, so let's look at you know, we've looked at the causes. Let's look at how to cut down, you know, belly fat. Yeah. What are the things that you have to do, you know, to cut it down?
To cut it down, yes. Part of what first thing I'm going to recommend to people is that they need to, number one, they need to pay attention to their belly. Once they observe that it's growing bigger than normal, they need to ensure that they exercise abdominal muscle, you know, that they can register in a gym whereby they can be counseled on best way they can get their belly tucked in, the exercises that can tuck in their belly. The second thing is they need to cut down on the kind of beverages that they take, which
beverages,
yeah, which doesn't have nutritional value. They get them excess, because one thing is every human being, depending on the kind of activities that you do every day, you have a sizable amount of calories, energy that you consume on daily basis. So why don't you give your body exact amount or something close to what the body needs to function well? Why would you load, if for example you need just 1600 calories of energy on daily basis and you load your system with like 5000 calories? So you need to find out what is your on average, what do you consume, kind of energy do you consume. So that will guide you on the kind of food that you eat and the sizes you take. So when people feel hungry, for example, when they feel hungry, they need to know, okay, fine, I mean, it takes about 20 minutes. Maybe I've bought meal now and I've eaten just 50% of the meal. Then I just hold on for like 20 minutes to find out if, you know,
the food will be cold though.
Yeah,
see. The guys just want to eat
it takes me hot. Good. I like that. It takes me to my next point, that the best is to make your own meal yourself. That's what takes me. It's part of what the process is. So you need to work at it to ensure that you make your own meal yourself. Fine, probably you pack your own lunch in the morning when you come to work, because that's when people are susceptible to go to canteens and restaurants to get food and all that.
And you know they don't want to waste the money, so they have to finish that food.
That's a problem, you know. Those are sacrifices that people, you don't have to finish all the food, because you keep doing this, in 10 years time you're gonna have belly fat, I can bet you.
Okay, so it accumulates.
It accumulates over time, so it's not a one-day thing. Then the other thing is alcohol. People who take a lot of alcohol, mm-hmm. they get, because this alcohol, the raw materials that are being used to produce them are from kind of high fructose, which our body don't understand how it can be processed. So because the body can process and understand this kind of fructose, the alcohol, which is the raw material alcohols are produced, it stores it as fat. So, and the places where this fat gets stored easily is the abdomen. So, you know, so those are, they need to stay away from excess intake of alcohol. They need to live a life of hydration. Take a lot of water. Take a lot of water. If you're thirsty, you're not thirsty. Then reduce your salt intake. It's very important. Yes, reduce your salt intake. The level at which people take salt is very bad. When you take a lot of salt, it has a way of retaining water, because the water you take is supposed to be sent out of the system. But when you take excess salt, then it gets your system retaining this water, and this water could get to the belly and of course add to the fat, and eventually you get protruded stomach, something like that.
Okay, so just in case you just joined us, this is Paradise 105.5 FM. It's the afternoon show on a Wednesday, and like we usually say, Wednesdays are never going to remain the same again, because the afternoon show is right here to make sure that you have the best that you can have in the afternoon, whatever you're doing right now. We've been talking to Mr. Clement from a lifestyle expert, and we've been talking about the cost of pot belly, and we're also going to be talking about how to reduce it. He's actually given out a few tips on how to reduce it. When we come back, I want to find out if there's a particular food that you can eat that will cut down belly fat and all that. But just in case you have any questions to ask, you could send it to us right now. We will be willing to answer whatever questions you have to ask about concerning belly fat. If you have it, you want to know how you can cut it down, you could get at us real quick. 081-2882-2614. The number is 081-2882-2614. We have Mr. Clement right here, a lifestyle expert, and he'll be here to answer whatever questions you have to ask. Right now, let's listen to this music. It's from Daft Punk and Pharrell Williams. This one is called Get Lucky. Enjoy it. We'll be right back in a bit.
Thanks.
Music of Daft Punk and Pharrell Williams is called Get Lucky, and we're getting lucky right here on Paradise 105.5 FM. This is the afternoon show. Hit us up on the Twitter at Paradise 105.5 FM, or you can hit me personally at Duke of Life. All right, loads of messages coming in. Please only text messages. Don't try to call us. We're not taking calls. We're taking your messages. Ask whatever questions you want to ask Mr. Clement. Lifestyle expert is right here in the studio, and we're talking about excess belly fat. Okay, before we went on that break, I said that we were going to talk about some myths about the whole belly fat thing. Now, are there any particular type of foods that you can eat that will cut down fat in the stomach?
Yes, the common is vegetables. When you take a lot of vegetables, a lot of fruits and all that, it helps to break down fat in a system generally. So when you take a lot of fried foods that are fried, people take chicken, meat, and all that are fried, it increases the level of fat in the system. So when you stay away from all this kind of food and you take more vegetables, you take more of cooked foods than fried ones, then it helps you.
What about the what do you call it, avocado?
Yes, avocado is good.
I hear
it helps. It helps in breaking down. Apple is also good. So avocado is one of the most popular, and apple is also good.
Almonds,
yeah.
Okay, now let's go straight up to your messages. Don't forget, you can still keep them coming. This one says, hello Duke, great show there, please keep it up. Thanks. Kudos to your guest, Mr. Clement. Is it true that weight occurs in the belly before anywhere else? It came from a canem in one say.
Yes, it's most likely. Most of cases when people have fat, it usually occurs more first in the belly, because because we have a lot of muscles around the stomach area, and when food is absorbed into the blood system, as through the mesenteric artery, it has the first branches are to the abdominal wall. So if you have a lot of excess fat being broken down going to your system, I can assure you that the abdominal muscle is going to have the larger share first. So if the person has a continuous way of eating fat, then he's going to have more of the fat around the abdomen.
Okay, so Tom says, Mr. Clement, I have pot belly, and I heard that crunches, that is sit-ups, help to flatten one's stomach, but I've done it for 4 months. I've done it for months now and no change. How I go do?
Okay, I want to first say that's good one, but you shouldn't just get impatient. I see a lot of commercials, you know, they just show someone who has a very protruded stomach, then
they just show him ripped.
They will show him ripped off. So it's not something that comes that fast. So people get, because of the commercials they see, because of the news they've heard, they tend to tense up and get very impatient. Just keep doing what you're doing, and of course watch what you're hitting, because if you keep loading the system and you keep doing sit-ups, then you won't have results. So you need to watch what you're doing, watch your lifestyle, you know. Don't hit heavy meals at night, because except you want to hit the meal, you want to hit it early enough so that you don't go to bed on time. Like you stay awake for like next 4 hours, then you can take it proudly, you can take something heavy, but it's not advisable because it has a way of storing excess fat.
Okay, Adiyanga from Etagbo says, please can someone be skinny and still have excess belly fat without being sick? And how can I know that I have excess belly fat?
Yes, it's very important, and it's true. You know, it's not, people look at having belly fat as something that has to do with your general body fat. So if you have belly fat, it's because you have excess abdominal fat, and you need to do a way to do that is to take measurement of your waist. You know, when you look at your waist, normally your waist is supposed to be like 30, and you look at the upper part of your waist, it's protruded, far more protruded, because the stomach is supposed to be flat, you know. But when you see it protruded, it's not a function of your general size, then you know that you have a tendency to have pot belly. And it's also important for people to do their BMI to find out what is their body mass index. And a way to do that is to divide your height. You multiply your height by 2, then you divide it by your weight in kg. then whatever you get between 20 and 25 is considered to be the normal. And once it goes beyond 25 to 30 to 35, then you should consider yourself obese. So it's not a function of when you look at people who look very fat, you say they are obese. It doesn't mean they are obese. Somebody who is thin could be obese. So it's very important. Person takes note of that. You divide your height, you multiply your height by 2. Then you divide your weight by your height.
Unfortunately, we don't have plenty of time to take all the messages, but let's take this last one. It's from Nomi. It says, please, what of ladies with pot belly owing to CS during delivery? How do they reduce the pot belly?
Yes, ladies, for example, when they have fat, when you're pregnant, you need to very, very careful the kind of food you eat. You know, everything boils down to the lifestyle we have. You can be pregnant and still have very low level of abdominal fat, and you could be pregnant and have very excess. So it's very important you watch out for your lifestyle. You do a lot of exercise. It's very important so that you don't get excess fat stored around the abdomen. So the fact that you have a CS doesn't mean that you're gonna have less fat, because the fat will build up there either way. So it's important we check our lifestyle. Everything boils down to the way we live, our eating habits, you know, the timing of our lifestyles, the timing of our eatings and all that.
Okay, so I wish we had much time to do this, but unfortunately we just have to go so we can play Youth Champion Sports. But I'm hoping that you had a great time listening to us. Thank you so much, Mr. Clement, for coming on the program. And we hope to see more of you when we're talking about something else. Okay, so don't forget that, like you said, your eating habits, you have to control it. Don't eat too much when you're hungry, because it takes 20 minutes for your brain to, you know, establish the fact that you're full. Whatever you do today will be history tomorrow, so only do the things that you are proud of. Shout out to everybody who listened to us. Shout out to Slim, who actually has been here with us as well. And also don't forget that there's a leadership conference coming up. It's called Leaders Then. There's going to be a whole lot of speakers right there. It's happening on the 18th day of May 2014, 2 p.m. that Sunday at the 520 Event Center, and it's free for all, but 50 seats are available. So if you want to attend, you could send send a text, or you call the number 08090339996638. All right, so it's free and it's happening right there at the 520 Event Center on Sunday by 2 p.m. All right, God bless you. We out of here. Have a fabulous day. This is Drake. Hold on, we're going home.